guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to shave my face on the camera, and while I'm doing that, I'm also going to answer some frequently asked questions about facial shaving. So I have posted videos on facial shaving on my Instagram a lot of times, and there are some frequently asked questions that I want to sit and answer today. So before I even start shaving, let me tell you that I have been shaving my face for more than 3 years approximately, and my skin has never felt and looked so good. I did try waxing and I also did try threading, but every time I did that I ended up with painful bumps and also very itchy skin, which definitely means that waxing and threading does not suit me. But when I tried shaving, I was very scared I might get hard growth due to the blunt ends. Even if it does not look hard, I thought like my skin is going to feel very rough, but that did not happen and I'm very happy about it. So until and unless you really try, you wouldn't know how a particular hair removal method works for you. So what I did before even started shaving, when I did it for the first time, I shaved a small patch right here just to see how it looks when my hair starts growing back. And for a week I did not see any hair growth, and my hair started I started feeling hair when I moved my fingers in the opposite direction after a week. So I was very happy that I did not get hard growth, which is actually a myth. So I then attempted, like, फिर मुझ में हिम्मत आई कि मैं अपने पूरे फेस पे कर दूँ, and I couldn't stop touching my face the entire 2 days after shaving, and there's no looking back. I am shaving for more than 3 years now, and I think this is the best hair removal method for your face if it suits you. Even dermatologists always recommend to shave face, so if it suits you, please stick to it. Okay, अब मैं ज़्यादा बात नहीं करूँगी, let's start shave. Now most of them are from Miniso or Lat Live. Now this one is from Miniso and it is extremely sharp, and अगर ध्यान से नहीं किया तो it can actually cause a cut. So I use this whenever I have a lot of time on hand. I take my own sweet time while I'm using this. Now why do I even use this? Is because it gives me a very clean shave. It also removes all the dead skin cells, the dead skin layer, and my skin feels so smooth, you guys. I love this one only when I have time. When I do not have time, I use this one. This is from Lat Live. It is super easy to hold and I can quickly use this. It is sharp but not that sharp jisse cut ho. So I also always have this in my handbag in case I need it, because there are days when I don't even know if I'm going to come back home. Like I go and stay at my friend's place or at my brother-in-law's place most of the times. So I carry this in my bag in case I need it. This is also from Miniso. I use it to remove so kya bolte hai, beach wala part, and also to shave the under eyebrow. I use the longer one to shave this one, like upper wala part, because it's easy. You will see how I do it in a bit. Then of course a tweezer to remove all the excess hair and a scissor to shape my brows. Let's start. I have already prepped my face. I have already washed my face with Murad cleanser. It removes all the excess oil, dirt, everything. It is like double cleansing but just one step. I'm going to start shaving now. Lekin, make sure that your face is squeaky clean before you shave, and sanitize the razor. I have already sanitized after I used it last time, so I'm not going to sanitize this now. I use razor on my cheeks, on my chin, on my nose, and on my forehead before I move to my eyebrows and upper lips. You are supposed to shave in the direction of hair growth in order to prevent any ingrown hair. Now I don't have much growth, even if it's been 2 weeks since I last shaved. Now I'm simply going to hold this here, and you're actually supposed to hold your skin taut, but since I have a mirror in hand, I usually do this in front of the bathroom mirror. But since I'm here in front of the camera, I cannot really go there. So hold your skin taut, let me show you how, like this, and then use a razor with your other hand. So right now I'm just going to do this so that my skin is tight and nice. Be very slow and gentle when you're using a razor, especially if using a new razor. Make sure you have a tissue so that you remove the excess hair from the razor. Now while I'm shaving, I'm going to answer some frequently asked questions. I get frequently asked if shaving is going to cause any hard hair growth. The answer is no, not at all. Shaving cannot change your genes. It is only going to have, like, your hair is only going to have a blunt end. But you cannot really see the blunt end, but you can definitely feel it when you move your fingers in the opposite direction. But it is not clearly visible and your skin is not going to feel rough, so that's okay. Shaving has not only helped reduce facial hair growth, not reduce, like, make my face hair free, but it also always adds a beautiful glow because the dead skin layer is all gone. Can you see how glowing this side looks? Like, there's nothing on my skin and my skin is looking so flawless. I think shaving has also helped me reduce dark spots because it exfoliates and, like, my skin just becomes smoother and more clearer every time I shave. With time, that has happened. Okay, now there is this shaving video on my Instagram, and I am going to go through the comments and answer some of the frequently asked questions. Shave karne ke baad hair mota aata hoga? Like I said, no, shaving is not going to make your hair hard. I mean, mota growth nahi hoga. Like I said, there is just going to be a blunt end. That's it. Your hair is not going to even look thicker than it used to be. Another frequently asked question is how to prevent aftershave razor bumps. Okay, so to answer that, always use a soothing ingredient, like any moisturizer or any product that you find is soothing after shaving. I would recommend using aloe vera gel or Clinique Moisture Surge Moisturizer. I really find it extremely soothing, so that is what I use. How frequently do you shave your face? So I shave once every 2 weeks or as required, talking about my face. Now if you ask me about my upper lips, I shave once every 4-5 days because my upper lip growth is faster than my face. Now when I'm shaving my forehead, I make sure not to go near the eyebrow because that I'm going to do later and I don't want to mess up the shape. After shaving, you know, your skin can actually feel a little sore or very little tingly if you wash your face after shaving, and that is completely okay. My face almost always feels a little tingly, especially after using a new razor. Next question, you have not even applied aloe vera gel or oil before shaving. Yes, you can definitely apply aloe vera gel or any good facial oil that you like, but I prefer shaving on dry face. I have tried using aloe vera gel, but I really love shaving on dry face. One, because I can really see the dead skin layer coming off, and secondly, my skin has better hold. There is better friction in case of I've also tried with facial oil, and I have ended up with a cut because the razor just slipped on my face, and that is something I do not want. Like, you can actually even see the mark right here. That is from a razor cut, and I do not want that. Dry shaving is the best for me, and it works for me. If you do not like to dry shave, you can use aloe vera gel or any facial oil that you like. Now, when I'm shaving hard to reach parts, like this part right here, I hold it like this and I stretch and I shave inwards. I feel it's easier that way. Hi, can ladies use this tip? Because hair growth is going to be double. Like I said, your hair growth is not going to be double. I have been shaving for more than 3 years, and I face the camera almost every single day. If that was the case, I wouldn't be sitting here making this video on facial shaving. I also used to shave my side locks, but I realized that it is not looking good, like it does not suit me. So what I do is I leave this part and I only shave the area around it, and it looks much cleaner and nicer. So I shave it like this without going towards the longer hair and just get rid of excess hair growth around it. Along with my face, I also make sure to shave this part right here because I have visible peach fuzz over here. And when I shave this part, I don't want it to look different. So I hold it like this and I shave it downwards. I'm now done shaving my face, my chin, and my forehead, also my nose. Like, I did not shave this part because wahan pe kuch hai nahi. You can actually even skip your nose, but if you have blackheads and whiteheads, you can shave because it is going to help you get rid of them as well. Now I'm going to do my brows and my upper lips. I get rashes and acne after shaving. It was the same when I waxed too. Any tips on how to avoid them? Now, hair removal works differently on different skin types. What works for me may or may not work for you, so you need to patch test and see what works for you. Waxing does not work for me, but it works for my friends, it works for my sister, but it does not work for me. So every skin is different. You need to try and test what works for you. Mine is shaving, yours might be waxing or something else. You might want to consider getting laser hair treatment for hard hair growth, because that is going to reduce visible hard growth, and then you can just simply shave your peach fuzz. Can people with PCOS use a facial razor? Yes, if you are comfortable shaving and if you don't get any rashes after shaving, you can definitely try facial razor. Lekin, keep in mind that your hair growth is going to be the same with blunt end. If you already have hard hair growth, you will still see hard hair growth, but it will also feel pokey because of the blunt end. So if you have PCOS and you have hard hair growth, you might want to shave very frequently, and that's completely okay. Now, moving to my upper lips, I am going to hold my skin taut like this and I'm going to shave in downward direction. You actually need to make sure that the skin is tighter. You need to hold it with the other hand, but since I'm doing it on camera, I am taking this risk but you can definitely do it in front of your bathroom mirror or any handheld mirror. Not handheld mirror, do it in front of a bigger mirror wherein you don't have to hold it. So it's easier to do, especially if you're doing it for the first time. I'd better do the other eye in front of the mirror and come back. I am back and I'm done with my eyebrows. Now one final thing that I have to do is cut the excess off using the scissor. Now it looks perfect. After you're done shading your face and your eyebrows, go ahead and rinse your face with water if you want, just to remove any hair that is stuck on your face, and then you can use your skincare products. Also, you can use aloe vera gel to soothe any inflammation and also to prevent razor bumps. I'm using the Chok Chok Green Tea Watery Skin from Tony Moly. I am obsessed with this one. It is so hydrating and soothing, and it also smells really good. I'm just going to pat it on my skin, and I do feel a teeny tiny bit of tingling, and that's okay. Now I'm going to use the Clinique Moisture Surge Moisturizer. I absolutely love this. Very hydrating, worth every penny. Can you see how great my skin looks? Super glowing, and it looks like it is drenched in water. If you have any more comments related to facial shaving, do comment below and I will definitely reply you all. See you guys very soon. We are done with today's video. Also, please suggest me some videos that you would like to see and I will have a look. Bye.